Jesus Christ! Think we're safe putting your security at the top of our list of suspects? They violated our privacy! The sons of bitches! Under my own roof! Wonder how long they've been keeping this from you.
Too long. This ends now. I am not letting any more of those freaks set foot! Ugh! My head.
Something wrong?
Don't worry about me. Do what you have to do.
Use meds. Intruder make a beeline here after Jeff tagged him?
Talking to yourself again?
More and more. Ever since this terrorist started stalking me.
Thank you.
connected to the wall-mounted screens. Wonder where else these cables run.
Transmitter's within reach of our mystery van. Wonder if Elizabeth has ever seen the car. There's a transmitter on the roof. Seems to be conveying a signal to a van out front. Know who it might be?
We never set up any transmitter. And I don't know a thing about any van, but my guess is it's SSI's.
Don't really see any other possibility. But we still don't know who they work for.
So what do we do with the transmitter?
Nothing just yet. Let me check the van first.
I'll wait here. Just don't tell Jeff anything for now, okay?
Sure, whatever. I'll call him once I know something more substantial.
That's fine. Just remember, it's the busiest time for Jeff right now. You can always come and talk to me.
Fine. I'll keep that in mind.
How about we take the wheels, V? That van could give us a slip any second.
Jam-packed with hardware. My optics don't see any manufacturer info or detect any mods. They don't mass-produce trucks like those. What are they doing? What are they hiding?
Earjacking. Huh. Could be the security firm or government. Media scouting for dirt on the paralysis?
Whoever it is, our intruder could be in there. I think it's time I went and said hello.
ブレインダンスにブロックされた。 Hey, how's it going?
And here I thought this day would be a dud.
How about a leg makeover?
Get her on her!
On the move!
Go, go, go!
You're gonna get a makeover!
The fuck?
I'm gonna rip off your fingernails and feed them to ya! Gonna get a nasty makeover! Thank you. I can smell your fear. The fuck? You done shit in your pants yet?
Pierced it, we're in.
Couldn't ask the NCPD for better records than this.
Pictures, medical records. Vulnerability to neuroplasticity. It's some kind of database. Brain scans, the paralysis biological casts, neuroplasticity.
Fuck. What about that? The blue shit.
Fresh neural links. They're not spying on them, Johnny. They're fucking with their heads.
Mean to say someone's literally controlling our upstanding politicians' minds?
Uh-huh. Red blots are memory residue in the hippocampus region. See how they're bleeding into the blue?
So what are we looking at?
They're planting new memories in their heads, modifying their personalities. This is big shit, Johnny.
Fuck me.
Got other guinea pigs besides the paralysis, too.
Quick, download the data. Whoever comes looking for it. That's your suspect.
Shit! They're wiping the data! We've been made. Now they know someone's been in their database.
Wonder if they also know who.
Any news?
Gonna wanna sit down for this. It's way bigger than we thought.
What is?
You're being brainwashed. Literally. They've scanned your minds and now using some kind of conditioning to...
Wait. Not on the Hollow.
Right. I'll come by.
No. You and I... We need to speak alone. I know a little ramen place in Japantown. Sending you the coordinates.
Right. See you there.
Fuck this!
Hey,
will you sit? Please? Thank you for coming.
Why are we meeting here and not at your pad?
Because I have something to confess. In private. Not in front of Jeff.
Okay. Confess away.
I'm sorry. My nerves are shot. I can't gather my thoughts.
Wasn't that long ago we last met. Something happened since then?
No. I mean, something did happen, though not recently. It's a long story. I don't quite know how to tell you. Where to even start?
Relax. No need to rush.
A while ago, I started noticing some changes in Jeff's behavior. His personality, he seemed to be changing right in front of me, becoming someone else.
How so?
He stopped reading, forgot the title of his favorite movie. Even his musical taste changed overnight. Once, I said we should visit his brother's grave, and he told me that he'd been an only child. That's when I started thinking something bad was happening. Something insidious. And not just with Jeff.
Notice any changes in yourself?
After some time, on several occasions, my friends pointed out that I was acting strangely.
Oh, that must have been hard.
It was. You know, it's at times like those you start to question reality.
So the whole time you knew what I could end up finding?
I don't know who, how, or why, but they're changing us. That concealed room in our apartment.
What about it?
I'm sure I'd seen it before, but must have somehow forgotten. I find that terrifying.
Mentioned any of this to Jeff?
I tried. I did. But he's blinded to everything. He just laughed, said I was imagining things. He once brought up a vacation that we never went on, swear to God. He went on about it in such detail, I almost started believing him.
Could be just you who forgot. Maybe they just wiped the trip from your memory.
Hell, I don't know anymore. Don't you get that?
Haven't told me the whole story yet, have you?
I saw a stranger in our apartment one night tinkering with the monitors. But I was in such a state by then that I didn't know if I could trust my own eyes.
So you didn't do anything?
I don't remember what happened. I talked to security the next morning.
Find it strange you took this to security instead of your husband.
I thought I was going insane. I wanted to see what was on the feeds first. There was nothing there, of course, so what was I supposed to tell Jeff? And then, the next day, I got a call.
Who was it?
Them. Whoever they are. There was a garbled voice on the other end. He never introduced himself.
They threaten you? Try to blackmail you?
They said I was walking on thin ice. That if we kept stirring up trouble, Jeff could have an accident. Then they wiped any record of our conversation. It was as if it had never happened. So I'm begging you, V. Jefferson can't find out about any of this. Ever. His life depends on it.
What if you're just saying what they programmed you to say? Just reading off a script based on thoughts planted in your head?
All I know is, I love my husband, and I want him to be safe, and happy.
Or that's what they want you to know.
You know what Jeff will do if you tell him? I know my husband. He'll start looking on his own. He can't find out about this. It'd destroy him.
You think if I tell him everything that he'll go and pick a fight he can't win?
I don't just think, I know. One thing hasn't changed. Jeff's still a fighter.
And he'll go down swinging. So how do we play this?
I'm going to tell Jeff that SSI was spying for his rival, Holt. You just need to confirm what I say.
Truly prepared to fire SSI? After the threats? It'd be brave, but risky as all get out.
What they're doing to us is one thing, but when you found that concealed room, I can't accept strangers spying on us while we sleep. Not under my own roof.
What difference does it make where?
I'll take full responsibility for anything SSI goes on to do. I'm just asking you not to get Jefferson involved.
Mm-hmm.
I'll add a meeting in Reconciliation Park to Jeff's schedule. He'll be waiting. Since I can't know if I'll remember this conversation tomorrow, I'm counting on you not to forget what I asked of you.
I won't. But that's all I can promise.
Goodbye, V.
Whole thing's fucked up, huh? Wouldn't want to be in her pants. Speaking of, overlapping memories, changing personalities. Remind you of anything? But hey, at least we know what we're up against.
So, in my pants, what would you do?
Some real rat bastards behind this. Someone's got to take them down.
Even by risking the Paralysis' lives?
Fuck knows what kind of shit a mayor controlled by puppet masters could pull. But yeah, you could end up putting their lives at risk. Or not. Tough choice, V.
Yeah?
It doesn't matter what you tell him. It doesn't matter what you think of doing or do. You can't change anything.
What?
We We know who you are. We know what you are. We know what you want. You are playing with fire. Don't dare cross the line.
Wait.
Fuck.
Hello, V.
Need to talk.
Yes, I know. Elizabeth filled me in. Sounds like I was right to hire a professional.
Elizabeth, what did she tell you, exactly?
Didn't get specific. Just that SSI was spying for that son of a bitch Holt. Guess you got more, though.
Strange as it may sound, don't got much.
There's gotta be something. You didn't find any hard evidence?
Sorry, it's all hearsay and speculation.
Like what?
SSI took money from all kinds of people. Holt among them. But it's a weak lead. Too weak. Nothing that can help you, Jefferson.
Damn! All right. I'll handle things from here.
Meaning?
First, I'm gonna win this damn election. Then, I'll find the motherfucker who spied on us. And if it was Holt, I'll find every last speck of dirt on him and bury him under the heap.
Well, then, good luck.
You'll get your fee soon. You already got my gratitude. Goodbye, V.
So, thoughts?
Somehow I doubt it's people who are behind this.
So, aliens?
Very funny. You're too young to remember this, but not so long ago, people talked about rogue AIs prowling cyberspace.
So, not aliens?
Doesn't matter who or what. Our guy's outmatched. They can do whatever they want. He's fucked, V.
hard to achieve peace if there is a demon never leaving. Contemplation is like the silence in the eye of the storm. You start to fade. You have no strong roots to this world. You are losing touch with yourself. You must purify yourself. Regain your equilibrium. I can help you. Sit down.
Okay, I'm listening.
In the city, you are cut off from nature. Metal, concrete canyons, neon eyes. The filth of the world suffocates you.
Sure is a new Zen garden.
You must become still. Restore the bond within yourself. You are the source. All which you must do is draw from it. Are you ready?
I'll give it a shot, why not?
I will give you a meditative brain dance that will liberate your consciousness.
Give me?
You can pay me however much you wish.
This should cut it.
Very well. The initial techniques of meditation are best undertaken with supervision. Let us begin. I will guide you. This is a meditation of the earth element. Spirit of nature, Mother Earth, I send you greetings. We are of one blood. I am you. You are me. Oh, Mother Earth, I and all other creatures from you created. Cleanse my body and soul from pain, sickness, impurity, and the negative energy from negative people, worlds, and dimensions. Give me the energy of life. Give me health, youth, wisdom, knowledge, strength, joy, happiness, and inner peace. We walk the earth through meadows, nature in full bloom. We remove our shoes, feel our bare feet touch the soil. We absorb the Earth's energy. We sense joy, tranquility, lightness, purity, our heart and soul. We walk the Earth. A butterfly rests on blooming flower. Bees are gathering nectar. Warmth and joy surrounds us. Our legs absorb the Earth's energy, filling every cell of our bodies. Our souls and spirits are cleansed. We thank you, Mother Earth, with our mind, body, and soul. There is no life without you or the other elements.
Hello? Nice vanishing trick.
Happy new gun owner, I hope.
Want to read my tarot?
Sure thing. Focus on the recent past and what you expect in the future. The Wheel of Fortune, reversed. You'll meet some setbacks in the future. Consequences of poor decisions, obviously. Justice, reversed. Be very careful with those you meet. Not all will be worthy of your trust. The High Priestess. Do not seek simple answers. Be open to your intuition, your subconscious, your dreams. The Moon. In her light, what was once far away and difficult to grasp becomes sharp and clear.
Wanna read my tarot?
The Wheel of Fortune. Justice. The High Priestess. The Moon.
What are you checking?
Okay. Whatever you want. Don't you remind these two?
Oh yeah?
get there.
Thank you.
today. Show me.
Thank you. on your grave when this is over!
I've got this. Hello? Where are you? I think it's one of ours! Contact! I'm engaging!